An official of a group pushing Sara Duterte Carpio to run for president says it would be most unfortunate if President Duterte ran against his own daughter in the vice presidential race. Former Davao City Councilor and Sara All Philippines 2022 co-convener Peter Lavinia hopes the president would just focus on dealing with the ongoing pandemic and that Duterte Carpio still changes her mind and guns for the presidency instead. Lavinia also fears voters will get confused during election day since there will be two Dutetes in the ballot. But the Commission on Election doesn't see an issue with this.
Wala naman pong problema dahil pre-printed naman po yung mga balota natin. So makikita mo dun kung sinong Duterte yan. Ano? Meron kang isang Sara Duterte, meron kang isang Rodrigo Duterte. Hindi naman siguro magkakos ng confusion yan because number one, the first names are there. And number two, they'll be in the same column. Pero again, I don't think there'll be any confusion.
The political analyst meanwhile suspects the administration is fielding the Bongo-Rodrigo Duterte tandem as a backup plan.
The way I look at it, okay, o pwede po kasi talaga na nagpa-plano lang naman, nag-orchestrate lang yung administration ng isang tinatawag nating backup plan or fail-safe, kumbaga. I call it a fail-safe plan. Just in case mag-prosper yung disqualification case kay Senator Bongbong Marcos. Pagka natuloy itong disqualification case na to, at least, meron yung administration na pangpalit, kumbaga, no? Para nandiyan si Senator Bongo at nandiyan nga si President Duterte, no? to take the cudgels. Okay? But we also need to understand na hindi nang man ganun ka basta-basta kadali ang dynamics pagdating sa power bases.
Father-daughter showdown for the country's second highest post may be in the horizon. President Rodrigo Duterte is expected to formalize his vice presidential bid for 2022 today, last day for substitutions for the upcoming elections. This comes just days after his daughter, Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio, took the spot of Lakas CMD's original vice presidential bet. In an online interview over the weekend, the chief executive said he will run against his daughter because he's not okay with her decision to settle for the VP post when she's been topping recent presidential polls. Recent presidential surveys. He claims she was influenced by presidential aspirant Bongbong Marcos, whose party, the Partido Federal ng Pilipinas, already adopted Duterte Carpio as its vice presidential candidate. Duterte also standing by his longtime aide, Senator Bongo, who filed his candidacy for president on Saturday under the Federalismo ng Dugong Dakilang Samahan. Go initially set his sights on the vice presidency, but Duterte says he urged him to run for president instead, following Sara's latest move.
Presidential daughter explains her decision to run for vice president in 2022. In a video posted on Facebook, Duterte Carpio said her move was a compromise to heed her supporters' call for her to run for president in the next election.
I have thousands of supporters who cried last October 8, and I cannot find it in my heart to make them cry again on November 15. After the deadline, the offer to run for vice president became an opportunity to meet you halfway. It's a path that would allow me to heed your call to serve our country and make me a stronger person and public servant in the years that lie ahead.
President Duterte expounds on his meeting with presidential candidate Senator Manny Pacquiao. Last week, he says Pacquiao pushed for a possible alliance to consolidate the Mindanao vote. But Duterte says he declined. Pacquiao, meanwhile, denied claims he gatecrashed into Malacanang. He asserts one Pacman party list, Representative Eric Pineda, told him Duterte was the one who requested for a meeting. He also said that he took that opportunity to apologize to Duterte if the latter got offended about him raising the issue of corruption in the government. Relations between the two soured after Pacquiao criticized Duterte's policy on the South China Sea and accused the health department of graft and corruption activities.
Meanwhile, Manny Pacquiao's visit in Cebu causes a stir. A Promdi party list, party presidential bet, was supposed to meet with local political leaders at a hotel when dozens of his supporters showed up. Some said they just wanted to see the fighting senator, but police claimed some supporters thought that Pacquiao was giving away cash.
Kulang kami naman power, ma'am. Pagdating gas, ma'am, kasi magbigay na ng pera dito.
Pasalamat ako sa mainit na pagtanggap ng mga tao sa atin. Hindi ko in-expect naman na hindi natin pinaalam na pupunta tayo. Pakiwasap ko sa kanila na sumunod tayo sa protocol, yung huwag magsiksikan masyadong.
Newly retired Philippine Police Chief Guillermo Eleazar takes his oath under Partido Reforma to officially join the senatorial slate of presidential aspirant Senator Panfilo Lacson. Eleazar will substitute for Paulo Capino, an advocate for disabled persons. But Lacson clarifies Capino was never meant to be a placeholder.
Patunayan si Pawi, he was a serious candidate. Hindi ito yung nag-file para maging placeholder. Actually, kasama namin siya sa mga lahat ng aming kamustahan. At siya talagang, he could very well represent the PWDs. Kasi walang ano eh, ang kahuliliang representative ng PWDs, si Senator Herrera eh. Matagal ng panahon. So sana may pagkakataon, sanang nagkaroon uli ng voice, ng boses yung PWD.
As for Eleazar, he says he will focus on peace and order bills if he wins.